Hello, good people of YouTube. In this video, we're going to be changing the coolant on a Volvo Penta D1-30 marine diesel engine.
Referring to the owner's manual, to drain the coolant, you should connect a hose to the drain cock. Then connect a second hose to the drain tap under the heat exchanger. In reality, and if you need to buy a replacement part, both these items are called drain nipples and both are identical. Clear plastic hose with an internal diameter of 10mm is exactly what you need to push fit onto the hose tails of the drain nipple.
The plastic pipe might be a little stiff and it might be too stiff to push on easy. So we'll just warm it up a little and then make it more pliable, and we can stick it onto the drain plug. For this light plastic, it only needs to be on low power. And just work it over, twisting it as much as you can over the heat gun. And there, just squeezing it on. That's the top of the heat exchanger. And there's the pipe, obviously there. And then this is, we'll take that off, and that's where the thermostat lives. To make sure that the water's going to run freely, we'll take the filler cap here off the expansion tank. So that's where that means air can now get into the system. We've got both sides of the engine there and there, and then both those pipes are running down into that bottle, which is at the lowest point that I can realistically get it. And we should be able to open the taps. And there it comes. Slowly but surely. Oh, I might be able to just make that run a little bit easier by changing the pipe shape there.
It's important to know how big your waste bottle needs to be, and also you need an idea how much you're going to need to fill the engine back up again. Referring to the manual, we can see we've got 4.1 litres in the engine, but remember, on almost all installations there'll be a hot water tank or calorifier which is external to the engine. I'm allowing for 5 litres of waste, which should be plenty.
Looks like the coolant stopped running out of the pipe. Now this is the heat exchanger side, so this is slightly higher up, but it does mean that we can now take the thermostat out. Oh, there's a bit of water coming out there. That's that. And then that's the gasket.
And there you can see the thermostat. It's just a push fit, but there is an O-ring gasket back there, so it might need a bit of help. Just a gentle twist with some long nose pliers just to unstick it, and it comes out easily by hand. Now there's always an argument between genuine parts and aftermarket alternatives, but when you do a price comparison like this, it's really difficult to justify the difference. So I'm going aftermarket. Gaskets in place, stat pushed home, and the cover keeps it all in place.
Got the hose pipe from outside, nice natural water. This is just for flushing, and we're going to just put that into the header tank there. And then we're going to turn it on, but it's going to be real gentle. Nice and gentle. So this is the rad flush. We're going to put that in so that we can flush the old girl out. Right, so that's the radiator flush run for about 10 minutes. The engine's still, you know, not warm, not hot to the touch, so it's not boiled over, which is what you're not supposed to do. So now we're just going to undo the bung again, but because this has got the radiator flush in it, where this isn't fresh water, so we're going to put the pipe on again and put it into the coolant thing.
So now we have to mix the coolant. I'm using 2 1-litre bottles. As shown previously, we need about 5 litres of mixed product. Now, there's almost no possibility that an engine installed inside a boat and wintered afloat in UK waters will ever see temperatures much below freezing. So the use of coolant in our case is more about reducing corrosion within the engine. So I'm making up 4 litres at 50-50, and then I'm going to top the rest up with fresh water. Always mix before you put it in the engine, and you'll note that I'm not doing this in the boat sink, but in a bowl. You can't take any risk of polluting the sea or river water. When the engine's almost full, it does take a while to bubble through to the header tank. But according to the instructions, the engine is self-bleeding. So once you know you've got your 4 litres in the engine, you should run it for an hour, checking the level in the header and topping up as required. So that's it. I hope you enjoyed the video. Please like and subscribe. And thanks for watching.